Dancing Academy. We are discussing parabola, and today we are discussing video lecture number 5. I hope you have already watched video lecture number 1 to part 4 before watching part 5. So today we are going to discuss this parabola, some more characteristics and some more conditions in which equation of parabola can be derived. So first let me describe what we have learned about the parabola and what is the meaning exactly. If I am writing the equation y squared is equal to 4x is the equation of parabola, and I am writing that this is a directrix, this is a focus, a comma 0, this is a vertex, that is 0, 0. So vertex is nothing else but tangent at parabola as well, this is 0, comma 0. And this directrix is what this point is called, minus a comma 0, and x plus a is equal to 0. This is the equation of directrix, and that we have learned already. Now, as per definition, we have learned that if there is any point on this P, x1 comma y1, then distance of this PS is equal to, distance of PS is equal to PM. Right? So, PS is equal to PM. This is what the condition. But if I am saying any distance from this edge, x1, so this distance is PS, focal distance, called focal distance. The point, distance of this point from the focus is called focus, focal distance. Distance of this point from this. If I am saying this is the x coordinate, so of course if I am drawing any perpendicular distance on it, that will represent x coordinate. So x coordinate of this edge here, if I am saying this is m, this is the perpendicular distance of course, and that coordinate must be described as x1, perpendicular distance, and perpendicular distance from here to y axis must be described as y. So y1 and x1, if I am saying that y1 and x1, and if I am taking any general point over x or y, so this point is y and this point is x. It means if perpendicular distance from point P, this point, to this tangent on vertex of parabola, this is y axis, tangent on the vertex of parabola, say this is PM and this is PN, PN. So PN, and here I can write some other variable, I can take here PN, and that is PM. Say this point can be written something as PMNO, P, P, Q, Q, say, I say. So PM and PN, if I am writing equation of parabola as y square is equal to 4x, and you know the lattice rectum is 4x, so we can write data way lattice rectum into perpendicular distance PM, PM, right, this is PM. PM is what? Perpendicular distance, that will represent y axis, and PN will represent x axis, so this is x axis, x coordinate is this. And y represent y, PM represent y axis and y coordinate. So PM square is equal to lattice rectum into PN. That is also one of the form of the parabola. Means, try to understand once again, if I am writing, let me write once again, if there is any point on this parabola, here is P, any point. P is any point and coordinate is xy, any point xy, anywhere it can be. So x is what? The perpendicular distance from y, this x axis is called y coordinate, say this is m, and this is a y axis. So perpendicular distance from y axis is x coordinate. So this is must be x and this is must be y. And equation of parabola is y square is equal to 4x. You know the lattice rectum is 4a. This is nothing else but lattice rectum. And this is what? If I am writing y square is equal to 4ax, then what is y? This is coordinate y. That is what I can write. PM square is equal to lattice rectum, rectum into what? X coordinate. Exponent is what? P, this is PN. Pn is x coordinate. So Pn. Pm square is equal to lattice rectum into Pn. That is also the way to understand the parabola y square is equal to 4x. So any point on parabola can define this characteristics. Pm square is equal to lattice rectum into Pn. And moreover, what is the distance of this? This distance is a. So again I can write here, if this is a parabola and this is a focus a comma 0, this is a tangent to the vertex. This is also called tangent to the vertex. Tangent to the vertex. So what is this length of this? S is this. Say this is V. So Vs is what? Vs is A. That is length of perpendicular from focus to the tangent at the vertex must be equal to A. Again, it is also considered like the length of perpendicular from focus to the tangent at the vertex of parabola. Vertex of parabola is, what is, that is A. That distance is A. Again, this distance is always described as A. This distance is A. And directrix is somewhere like this. So from, if I draw a length of perpendicular from this to this, then what will be that distance? This is also A. So A plus A will total will be 2A. So if this will represent the directrix of parabola, then also length of perpendicular from focus to directrix is length of perpendicular from focus to directrix is what? 2a. Focus to directrix is 2a. And therefore, we can define length of lattice rectum can be calculated like is equal to twice of length of perpendicular from focus to vertex of parabola and 4 times of length of perpendicular from focus to directrix. Right? So you can remember these 2 important points, and this will be very, very helpful for you to find the length of lattice rectum. Without deriving the equation of parabola, one can find this and you will be able to analyze this. So this is very, very important concept. I am just writing here. This is the important concept in which one can find the length of lattice rectum without finding the equation of parabola even. And the second thing is that this length is always A and this length is always A. Today we will discuss some more questions on the basis of these characteristics, and definitely you will be able to understand the parabola well. Here, this is the equation of parabola y square is equal to 4x, and accordingly we can derive all these things. So let me write some questions and thereafter we will discuss this. First question I am taking on today is, focal length of a point of parabola y square is equal to 16x is 16, find the coordinate of the point. Find the coordinate of the point. Find the coordinate of the point. This is the question. Now, this is the question. Find the coordinate of the point. Now, we can draw a parabola. This is the parabola shape. Parabola is this. Y square is equal to 16x. Of course, we can say this parabola is passing through origin and here focus is a comma 0. And what will be that a? Indeed, comparing with y square is equal to 4x, we will get, what is that? 4a is equal to 16 and therefore a is equal to 4. You know, parabola is this side, so directrix must be this side. And what is that equation of directrix? It x plus a is equal to 0, that is x plus 4 is equal to 0. X plus 4 is equal to 0. And this coordinate must be 4 comma 0. A comma 0, that will be 4 comma 0. Okay? Now, using the same path, since any point, now we have to find a point. We don't know which point lie on it. So I can consider, let P, X1, Y1 be any point lie on the parabola. So I can start from here only. Let P, X1, Y1 be any point lies on parabola, y square is equal to 4ax, and therefore it will satisfy the equation, that is y1 square is equal to 4ax1. Now I can also write this. What is that? Y1 square is equal to 4ax1, and if I draw a length, say this is a PM is equal to PN, right? So PM and PM, PM and PN, if I consider, then what will happen? Say, or PS even, PS is equal to PM, if I draw directrix like this, then this is a PS, right? Using this fact, PS is equal to PM. That can be also written like this, PS is equal to PM. So using the same path, if this is a focus, PS is equal to PM, and equation of parabola would be, what is this x1 and y1? So using the same path, here, what will be the coordinate of x1? Considering this 4a, x1, a is 4, and y square is equal to 16x1, it will satisfy the parabola. It is not 4x, but it is just 16x. So this is 16x1. Y1 square is equal to 16x1. So PS is what? PS is focal distance. This is the focal distance of parabola. PS. PS is focal distance of parabola. Right? So PS is what? PS can be defined as S and P. This is SP. SP is what? What is this SP? SP is 16. That is what SP. SP is 16. Since here 4A, that is SP is 16. And since SP, PS or PS you say, PS is 16. And since PS is equal to PM by definition of parabola, so PM is also equal to 16. PS is 16, PM is also 16. Why PS is 16? Because this is 4. This is the focal distance, and focal distance is already given 16. PS is distance of this point from focus, and this is given 16. So PS is 16 already given here. Here PS is 16 given. So PS is equal to PM as per definition of parabola. So PM is also 16. length of perpendicular from point to this line is this. And what is this distance? Will you say this is the distance from this equation is, what is this? If this is 4, this will be what? 4 plus 4, 8. The distance is x1 plus 4. And this distance is what? PM is 16. PM is the length of perpendicular from point to the directrix. PM is 16. And therefore, we can write this equation as what? X1 plus, this directrix is x1 plus, what is this? x1 plus 4 is equal to 0. And what is this? X1 plus 4 is equal to 0. Think about this. What is x1 plus 4 is equal to 0? And x1 plus 4 is equal to 0. And the distance is, this equation is from this point, x1 plus 4 is equal to 16. Because directrix is PM. And therefore, x1 is what? X1 is, here it will be 8, 12. X1 is 12. Now using the same fact, using this, x1 is equal to 12. Now using this in equation 1, putting this value in equation 1, what will happen? Y1 square is equal to 16 into 12 and y is equal to 8 into, what is this, plus minus 4 will come from here, 2 will come from here and 3 will remain. So y1 is equal to plus minus 8 root 3 and therefore point is, what is point? 12 comma 8 root 3 and 12 comma minus 8 root 3 are two focal points, two points on parabola. Right? This is the thing what we have to do. Try to understand once again. If P, X1, Y1 be any point lies on the parabola Y square is equal to 16X, Y1 square is equal to 16X1, then they must satisfy the equation. And PS is given 16. PM is length of perpendicular from point to the line. If you draw length of perpendicular from this point to this line, then what will happen? Using the formula of length of perpendicular from point to the line, if this is point x1, y1, think like this, and this is a line, x plus 4 is equal to 0, then what will be the length of perpendicular? Say if I am writing this PM, writing this separately, PM is equal to x1 plus 4 upon under root 1 square plus 0 square. So that will be x1 plus 4. So this is what x1 plus 4 will be the length of PM. And that is why I have written here x1 plus 4. And this is 16 because PS is equal to PM and this is 16 given. So x1 will be equal to 12. Now putting the value of x1 here, you will be able to get coordinate of y, and therefore two points lie on this will be 12 comma 8 root 3 and 12 comma minus 8 root 3. I hope you got this, how to develop this, right? Okay, let me write the next question. I hope you got it. Okay, this is very good question. Focal distance is what? Focal distance is called the focal length, or focal distance is the distance of any point on the parabola from the focus, is called focal length or focal distance. Now, let me write the next question. Find the equation of parabola. Find the equation of parabola which focus is at 0, 0 and tangent to the vertex of parabola y plus 1 equal to 0. This is what we need. Let me draw a diagram in which one can write. This is x-axis and y-axis. X-axis, this is y-axis. X minus y plus 1 is equal to 0 is a line where x is equal to, if I put x is equal to 0, y is equal to minus 1, and x minus y is equal to y is equal to 0, then x is equal to minus 1, x is equal to minus 1, 0, minus 1, 0 would be this point, right? And if I put x is equal to 0, then y would be 1, means this. This is a line which will be x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. I think you got it. Now, this is a tangent to the vertex and parabola is somewhere like this. So that vertex will be like this. Vertex is here only. At focus is at 0, 0 and vertex is there. You know, vertex is here. So this is a parabola. If I am constructing it truly, I can get it. This is a focus. This is a vertex. Here tangent is like x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0 and tangent is always perpendicular to the axis of parabola because axis is, this is the called axis of parabola. Now, if I am trying to write this, if this is a vertex, then directrix will be also a line parallel to what? This vertex tangent to this. So directrix will be somewhere like this. Directrix will be somewhere like this. And that will be also equation line parallel to this will be x plus minus y plus lambda is equal to 0. Any line parallel to x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0 can be written as x minus y plus lambda is equal to 0. Now, let me write this solution. Solution of this question. Any line parallel to x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0 is what? X minus y plus lambda is equal to 0. Now, length of perpendicular from this edge to the vertex is a and length of perpendicular from this to this is 2a. You have learned in the previous question. So, length of perpendicular, since if I am writing this point is O and this point is M and this point is N or this point is N and this point is M, then OM is equal to twice of N. Therefore OM is equal to twice of ON. Remember this, why it happened? We have learned this, that Y square is equal to 4X. Then this is a focus, then this point is A and directrix, then this point is also A. So distance of from this to this is 2A and distance of this is A. So this distance is twice of this distance. Use this concept everywhere and therefore I can write here OM is equal to twice of ON. OM is nothing else but length of perpendicular from point to the line. Again use the previous formula. What will happen? Length of perpendicular from point to the line again. I can use it. Ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under root a square plus b square. But what is a here? 0, 0 plus lambda upon under root 1 square plus 1 square. 1 square plus minus 1 square. Truly I can write here. Although it will be not make any difference. Twice of length of perpendicular from 0 to line is 0 plus 0, right? Plus, what is that? 1 divided by 0 minus 0 plus 1 divided by under root 1 square plus minus 1 square. So, using the same characteristics, I can write lambda upon root 2 is equal to, this will root 2 is equal to twice of 1 by root 2. If I remove lambda from one of the side, it will come lambda is equal to plus minus 2 by root 2 and this side also root 2. Root 2, root 2 cancel and therefore lambda is equal to plus minus 2. But the distance from this to this is 1. So in that way, it will be lambda must be positive. Plus 1, lambda must be positive. The distance is just double. Easily one can write distance between two parallel lines. So lambda must be 2. We can take lambda positive. So lambda is equal to 2 is, because since it lies in which quadrant? In second quadrant. Why? Because directrix of course lies in second quadrant. Right? Huh? So that is why lambda is equal to 2. Taking this lambda is equal to 2, the equation of directrix will be x plus x minus y plus 2 is equal to 0. This is the equation of directrix. We have focus, we have directrix, right? That is PS is equal to PM can be applied here. And now distance of from point to the focus and distance from this is directrix will be same. This is the equation of directrix. So all we did this just to find the equation of directrix only. And by using this equation, now we can derive the equation of parabola. Now, got it? Okay. So let me write now the equation of parabola. How the equation of parabola can be derived. So, if P be any point, now I can write here, if P x1, y1 be any point on the parabola and k is foot of perpendicular from p to directrix, then PO is equal to PK, right? PO, this is a point and that is PK, say anyway. Distance are same. So, P is any point, that is x1, y1 be any point. And therefore now, using the same, x1 square plus y1 square under root PO is this. And PK is equal to what? Length of perpendicular x1 minus y1 plus 2 divided by under root 1 square plus 1 square. This is what? Now, squaring both the sides, what will come? On squaring both the sides, this will come like 2, root 2, square will be 2, x1 square plus y1 square is equal to x1 square plus y1 square plus 4 minus plus 4x1 minus 4y1 minus 2x1 y1. So, using the same 2x square, it will come x square plus y square plus 2x1 y1. From this side, it will come this side positive. Minus 4x1 plus 4y1 plus 4 is equal to 0. And therefore, locus of x1 y1 is given by x square plus y square plus 2xy minus 4x minus 4y plus 4 is equal to, this 4 will come this side, it will be minus 4. Minus 4 is equal to 0. Because 4 will come this side, it will be negative. 2x square minus x square will remain x square and 2y square minus y square will remain y square. So this is the equation of parabola. This is the equation of parabola. You can derive this type of equation of parabola with given different geometrical conditions, and some more questions we will discuss in upcoming classes. Be regular and keep watching our videos on YouTube. Thank you very much for watching this.